Welcome to Matters Financial and Geopolitical from a Frontier. I hope the week's gone well. Let me start with some macro thoughts. Bump in the night. FX flash crashes put regulators on alert. I wrote about this in February this year. Currency puzzles, I said. We have witnessed spectacular and exponential moves, typically in the early hours when most of the world is in the land of nod and liquidity is at its lowest. You might recall a night when sterling tanked 10 big figures, a night when the rand flash crashed, and actually I think we're going to hit those levels again. And even this year we saw the Aussie get creamed. Now this article is very good. The increasing frequency of flash crashes in the $5.1 trillion a day foreign exchange market has regulators scrambling for answers. Sudden, violent, and often quickly reversed price moves are now a regular occurrence in world currency markets, often during the so-called witching hour, a period of thin trading between 5 and 6 p.m. in New York, when currency dealers there have powered off and colleagues in Tokyo have yet to sign on. The question is this a new normal or is it a canary in the coal mine sort of thing, said Fabio Natalucci. Mini crashes already occur roughly every 2 weeks in the FX market, according to a study by Pragma, a company which creates computer trading models. Computer models known as algorithms or algos have largely replaced humans in currency trading, helping banks to cut costs and boost the speed at which deals are done. The models are designed to execute trades smoothly by breaking down orders into small pieces and searching for platforms where liquidity is plentiful. And because fragmented forex markets depend on algos for a constant stream of price quotes, by one estimate there are 70 odd trading platforms, a widespread shutdown causes volumes to nosedive, making the price moves more dramatic. The first of this year's notable crashes came on January the 3rd, when the yen spiked suddenly against the dollar after Tokyo markets closed. It jumped 8% within the space of 7 minutes against the Australian dollar and 10% to the Turkish lira. A Reserve Bank of Australia report noted that several flash episodes have been recorded during the witching hour. It was also during this illiquid period on October the 7th, 2016, that sterling collapsed 9% in early Asian trading, falling to around 1.14 from 1.26 within minutes. The RBA's analysis of all these flash crashes concluded algorithmic trading strategies likely acted as amplifiers. Up to 70% of all FX orders on platform EBS, one of the top two venues for currency trading, now originate from algorithms. In 2004, all trading was undertaken by humans. And this is what I was writing about in that article, Currency Puzzles. Spectacular and exponential moves, typically in the early hours when most of the world is in the land of nod and liquidity is at its lowest. I said wizards and gremlins stalk the night. Once upon a time, the FX market was a voiceover market. Today, it's entirely screen-based and algorithmic, and high-frequency trading is a big component. And it's resulted in a dramatic change of the market microstructure, particularly in the way liquidity is provided. Very interesting article, well worth reading. This is a wonderful chart via J.S. Blockland, and look at it and compare it to 2016. In 2016 was when I wrote that piece, Mirrors on the Ceiling, the pink champagne on ice. And I said, if volatility spikes, positions are going to be reduced en masse, or to put it another way and borrow the lyrics from the Hotel California, mirrors on the ceiling, the pink champagne on ice. And she said, we are all just prisoners here of our own device. Last thing I remember, I was running for the door. I had to find the passage back to the place I was before. Look at that chart. It's practically a mirror.